had a string of hit singles and albums, toured the world, and recently made her Hollywood acting debut. Whilst working on becoming everyone's favourite Geordie and a bona fide national treasure, she's also taken the time to record a brand new album called A Million Lights. She's here today to perform a few exclusive tracks from it, and I'm excited. So welcome to this T4 Cheryl special. Hello, Cheryl.
Hi.
Welcome to your very own special.
Thank you.
This is a good set, I think.
It is. It's amazing.
We've spent all the money on lights, so we don't have any chairs.
Yeah, exactly.
Just so boxes.
Yeah, just the boxes the lights came in.
But the lights are good.
Yes.
And we're here to talk about your... We've got a lot of stuff to talk about. We're going to talk about your new album, yeah. A Million Lights. Why is it called that? It's a lot of lights.
There's actually a track on the album called A Million Lights.
Okay.
Yeah. So originally I was going to call it something else, and then we got A Million Lights.
Uh-huh.
Loved the track, loved the title. It worked with everything I was doing with the album artwork,
yeah.
And... You know, the bright colours, all of that.
Yeah. So this is album number 3.
Yeah.
The last two, very successful, going to number 1. Is there, like, a nervousness or an excitement about the success of number 3?
There's more of an excitement on this one. The first one was the scariest thing I've ever done in my life, and I missed the girls, like, terribly. I hadn't even anticipated how much I would miss them. The second one, I got sick in the middle of recording.
Right.
With malaria.
Yeah.
Not fun.
Not fun
so
at all.
So I kind of have a little
Don't
bit
go hand
of...
in hand, malaria, recording
yeah,
an album.
No.
Not good.
So this one, I've took like a year to record.
Yeah.
I've completely nailed it, what I wanted.
The second album, people always say, is the difficult one.
Yeah.
What would you say the third one was?
Exciting.
Yeah,
just ready. You just want to do it now, uh-huh. Yeah.
Now, not a lot of people will know this. I never knew this till I did my Cheryl research. But you've written and co-written in the past. Did you do any of that on the new album?
Yes, I did quite a lot actually. Some of it, because I decide what to put on at the end. Some of it I didn't choose to put it on. But no, I did a lot of writing.
What stuff you wrote?
Yeah.
Like,
I just get excited when you hear. A song for the first time and it's complete and it makes you feel things. Because I'm always thinking visually too, like when I hear a song, how it's going to look when I perform it. And when you write it, it's a different feeling.
Mm-hmm. Talk to me about Call My Name, first single from the album.
Yeah.
It's a huge record. I'm fully obsessed with it.
Oh, thank you.
Really, really am. Was that an obvious first single?
Yeah, it was so obviously first single.
It's big, isn't
you
it?
You just hear the do-do-do-do-do. Yeah. It makes you want to dance.
Uh-huh.
So. I knew that was the first one because, again, visually, I was excited.
You do to me, need you to stay with me. I
How was it performing it on The Voice and doing that swan dive? Which made me, that was terrifying to watch. Like, it freaked me out, because it was so instant and so off there.
Well, I went into rehearsals and originally they had me just being lowered down very politely into the dancers, because we weren't going to take the stairs. That was never going to happen.
No, no stairs for sure.
Too polite.
No,
I don't do stairs. and I knew I'd be wearing heels. So I went into rehearsals and they said, this is how you're coming in. Yeah. And I said, no, let's do something a bit more exciting. What I was thinking, I have no idea. But once I'd told myself I was going to do it, then I had to.
The song was produced by Calvin Harris.
Yes.
How's it working with him? Because he's sort of he's like sort of the factory
the
of
man
hits,
of the
isn't
moment.
He's the man, yeah.
Yeah, he's so talented. Mm-hmm. And it was exciting that it was his work. He wrote and produced it as well.
Right.
So he's super talented. It's a pleasure to work with talented people always.
Did you know Calvin before? You must have run into him before.
I've run into him a couple of times. One time he was at the X Factor with a pineapple on his head.
Oh, of course he was.
Yeah.
He got thrown out.
Yeah.
He got thrown out and then I had to go on Extra Factor because he got barred.
Oh, really?
Yeah. True story.
That's funny. So why don't we hold
on? You also collaborated with will.i.am.
Yes.
Of course. How have you been enjoying his mentoring on The Voice?
Well, it's just like me and him in real life. That's the kind of stuff he says to me. So I've actually enjoyed other people getting to know him. He talks in riddles, though. You have to really listen hard, and he talks in metaphors.
What advice does he give you?
We don't have tactics. We stay fresh. We have TikTok.
I like that.
He's cool.
I like that. Now, another collaboration on the album, Wretch 3-2.
Yes.
Which I can't say very well.
Wretch 3-2.
Wretch 3-2. I can never, ever say it. How did you hook up with him? He's here today. He's going to perform with you.
Wretch actually heard the track and loved it and wanted to be on it. So normally it would be you saying, look, I've got this song.
Yeah.
Are you interested? But he was like, this song's amazing. I want to be on it. Which was really lovely for me. He's going to perform today.
I know, I'm ready for that. I love him.
Yeah,
he's a good
so
guy.
Nice.
Nicest guy.
So cute. We can love like this. You broke me down. Do I even exist? After everything, gave you everything. I lost everything. Love is so lonely. No. I don't want to run no more. Can't believe in all the I did for you. And I don't want to hurt no more. Oh, my heart, it must have been too big for you. So caught up in the love I felt for you. I burnt out like a flame I'd held for you. But it never was enough. I never got your love. I loved you so much, but you never gave up.
Everything, gave you everything. I lost everything. love is so lonely. No, I don't wanna run no more. Can't believe in all the shit I did for you. And I don't wanna hurt no more. Oh, my heart, it must have been too big for you. So caught up in the love I felt for you. I burned out like a flame, I'd help for you. But it never was enough. I never got your love. I loved you so much, but you never gave up.
That is it for part one. We will see you after the break for more Cheryl. She'll be singing, she'll be dancing, she'll be answering questions from me. We'll see you in a minute. Welcome back to our Cheryl special, which wouldn't be complete without Cheryl herself.
Hi.
Hi, Cheryl.
Hi.
Now, I read that you have a different favourite track from your new album, A Million Lights Every Day.
Yeah,
what's your favourite today?
Sexy Then a Mother.
That's my favourite today.
Is it?
So weird.
We must have been thinking
the same
thing.
It's one of those days, isn't it?
It is.
What was the aim when you sat down to do album number three? What did you want to accomplish with this?
Well, I knew I wanted to have a specific sound. Mm-hmm. And I've actually tried a few different directions in the process.
Mm-hmm. Is there a ballad on it?
There's a couple.
There's a couple of ballads,
yeah.
Okay.
It's actually quite a mid-sounding album overall. I've got a few dance tracks on there, a lot of dub sounds. Mm-hmm. But overall, it's quite a mid-tempo.
Okay. I'm ready for some mid-tempo show.
Yes, exactly.
You spent a lot of time in America. I keep seeing pictures of you in LA.
I recorded a lot of the album out there.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Why did you decide to do that? Just because sunny?
Well, that's a big part
There's
of it.
There's a beach.
When you wake up in the morning and it's sunny, you just feel in a different place. But no, a lot of the people I work with live there or work out there.
And do you have dreams of sort of cracking America? A lot of British people have been doing it, Adele and Florence and One Direction and The Wanted. Is that the aim for you?
It's not the aim. I'm really, really happy being home. I'm such a homebody. Mm. I get homesick really easy.
Yeah.
If it happens, I'll do it and I'll commit myself, but I haven't made plans.
It's not like a thing.
Nah.
No. What we want you to do this year, Cheryl, is to do your own tour, the Cheryl Tour. Is this going to happen?
I believe so.
Yeah? It's going to happen. That's really exciting.
I hope so.
Yeah, that needs to. I think that'd be the best thing about being a pop star.
Well, it's the best thing for me.
Yeah.
Going on tour is like what we do this for, you know?
Yeah. It's,
once everything's done, you've got your songs, and you see your fans singing back to you, it's the best feeling ever.
Get stuck in a phase. I can see the sun is shining bright.
Who did you idolise when you were younger, pop star wise?
All the Destiny's Child. Yeah. I love TLC, Mary J. Blige. Yeah.
Who else are you a fan of at the moment? What other pop stars are you into?
Well, I could tell you the obvious people like Rihanna. Mm-hmm. I'm excited for Chris Brown's album. I'm just so happy to have Beyonce back.
I know, ready, back.
I mean, I feel selfish saying it. Because she did that
the
little
thing.
The
baby's lonely, but we're
That's
entertained.
That's okay, yeah, we're entertained.
And how was it meeting Beyonce?
Well, I completely embarrassed myself.
Really?
Yeah, I turned into, I was starstruck. And she was starting to tell me this story, how she'd taken inspiration for one of her dresses from a Girls Aloud video.
Oh, wow.
And I wish I had have absorbed that information a little bit more at the time, but I was too busy trying to tell her what I thought of her. It was actually really quite embarrassing. And my mother was there too, just to embarrass her a little bit more.
Just a little bit more.
And I had a glass of wine.
Oh, you were just like a mess. Sorry, Beyonce. next year as well, 10th anniversary since Girls Aloud released their debut. Oh, this year?
November.
November, got it in the diary. Is there going to be a reunion?
There's going to be something.
Okay.
I mean, it definitely...
I want it to be bigger than the Jubilee.
You do?
Like, in the Queen's face.
I mean, a decade in music is a massive milestone for anyone, so we have to celebrate that together.
Yeah. What has been, like, the standout highlight? Is there something that you always look back on and think, wow?
I mean, I've got because it's been long, I've got loads of those memories.
Yeah.
The Brits was a real honour for us because we'd been together for 6 years before we even got one.
Yeah.
So when we actually got one, it was like, and it was voted for by the fans. It was a special feeling, a nice feeling for the band. And then when I had the solo record go to number one, that was indescribable. I've had loads of special moments. I've been really fortunate.
Yeah, they're good moments.
Yeah.
Well, Cheryl, lovely to talk to you.
And you.
Nice to see you. I'm excited for the new album.
Thank you.
Good luck with it.
Thank you.
Thanks, Cheryl.
Better, is it worse? Are we sitting in reverse? It's just like we're going.